all of mid-Missouri, dealing with at least 2 to 3 miles of visibility due to that fog. A closer look at Jefferson City, especially as we head along the Missouri River, we could see some denser fog as well. Just keep that in mind as you head out the door. And in my next full forecast, there is some relief in sight. We're going to be tracking some rainfall moving into the area late Tuesday night with the potential for some strong thunderstorms. I'm tracking a few showers and thunderstorms across southern portions of mid-Missouri this evening. I'll have that and the latest on the cool down for this week up next. Coming up next, I'm tracking potential tropical cyclone number 7. I'll have the latest on how it could affect mid-Missouri next. 7 days, and you can see those low temperatures near 70 degrees. That kind of just goes to show you how much humidity is in the atmosphere, because your temperatures can never go lower than your dew points. So if your temperatures at night are in the 70s, it means your dew points are going to be in the 70s. Dew points in the 70s are uncomfortable, and that may have been a little bit too much explaining, but it's going to be uncomfortable is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, too long, don't read. It's going to be uncomfortable.
Exactly.
Thank you, Luke.
And this evening, even took a picture outside of our studio earlier on, right around 6:30. We can see that is the sun indeed right there. It doesn't really have those bright shining rays that it usually has. The smoke obscures much of the sunlight that we have. The ridge of high pressure off to our southwest. And what's going to happen is we're going to have little bubbles of low pressure that ride along that ridge and push their way down to the south. So the best chance of seeing that rainfall is going to be on a line from about Highway 63 and points to the east. If this ridge pushes back just a little bit, we could see those rain chances increase further to the west. So that's something we're going to track over the next several days as those.
Luke, between the 9 o'clock show and now, you've got some pretty cool photos from some viewers.
Yeah, we've got about 5 or 6 photos in
that's
the past
awesome.
15 minutes, trying to get it all together for you guys.
Yeah.
A couple pictures that we do want to show you. Kelsey from Cowood, Missouri, sending us this photo in of, you know, that dot right there in the sky. That is the sun. What's happening is the smoke acts like sort of a barrier for some of the sunlight. It was worse in some places like Holt Summit. Eric Cunningham sending us this picture from Holt Summit, where you can barely even see the sun. The sun is still well over the horizon for 2018. You can see on that 7-day forecast, pretty dry.
Yeah, definitely. And lows not dipping down too much. 58, though. That's not too bad.
Again, like I said, open up the window, give that AC a break.
Yeah, definitely. All right, Luke, thanks so much.
At times, as it continues to press off to the west, however, it's going to run into this high pressure system that's going to help steer it off to the south of Hawaii, leaving the center of the storm about 160 miles away from the mainland. Between the 10th and the 15th, where we're likely going to be seeing 50s, 60s, and 70s across the Midwest, with nighttime lows potentially in the lower 50s. As you can see, June ended off right around 6 degrees above where we should have been for the month, so that hot weather we saw in our May continues into our June and will likely continue into our July as well. You can see Pilot Grove, Bunsen within the next 10 to 15 minutes and headed to Windsor Place by about 10:45. This obviously doesn't look like much on the radar, but we could see a few rain showers over the next hour through Cooper County. A little more impressive down to the south in portions of southwestern Osage County as this line of thunderstorms continues to push off to the east at about 35 miles an hour, affecting places like Lynn and Bell within the next 5 to 10 minutes. Kanan, you're going to be feeling those effects in the next 45 minutes and then into Gasconade County near Owensville in the next 45 minutes as well. Again, we're not really looking at much in the way of severe weather with this. We might see some dime-sized hail, maybe some 40-mile-an-hour winds, but nothing that's going to be causing any damage. And overnight tonight, we're going to be seeing those storms mostly south of Interstate 70, 75. Well, we typically associate high-pressure systems with cooler, calmer weather in the weather world, and that's exactly what we're seeing happen right now, actually, and that's actually beginning to steer Florence as well over the past several days. This has kind of been a blocking mechanism up against this tropical depression as it continues to kind of feed its way into this area of high pressure. And something just to kind of help you imagine what high pressure actually is, you have to think of the center of the high pressure as where that air pressure is the greatest. Think about when you take a bottle of water and you squeeze it. You're increasing the pressure inside of that water bottle. What happens when you let that air go? Okay, maybe it's a little more dramatic than that in the atmosphere, but think about it in the way of the air pressure being forced away from the center of that greatest pressure. That's exactly what's happening here. All that air begins to sink down to the surface. That prevents any sort of thunderstorm growth with height in the atmosphere, and it's beginning to feed dry air into that tropical depression right up into the center of that storm as that air continues to circulate around Florence and continues to get driven up into the atmosphere. Low pressure works a little bit differently. It's kind of like a vacuum. It begins to pull that air to that center of that lowest pressure. pressure. So that's kind of the yin and the yang of the weather world, those high pressure and low pressure systems. You can see here across mid-Missouri that high pressure keeping us quiet. Warm afternoons on tap through Thursday. We can see those temperatures easily 5 to 10 degrees above the average of where they should be this time of year. You can see 91 doing it for us on Tuesday. Those feels like temperatures each of these days could be anywhere between 91 and 94 degrees. So make sure you do have plenty of water if you have any sort of extended outdoor activities planned. And some afternoon storm chances are possible, especially as we head into Thursday. You can see as we progress future track throughout the next several days, some spot PM storms are possible. I think that better chance lies as we head into Thursday before we watch a cold front track into mid-Missouri. And you can see that cold front pushing its way to our area, bringing us a chance at some widespread rainfall across our region. That cooler weather is going to be situated just to our north, where those fall-like temperatures will kind of be in control for the northern portions of the United States. It's really going to be their first big shot of fall, Sarah, that warm and muggy condition staying off to the south of that cold front. You can really see it here across mid-Missouri, too, where we take those temperatures back down to the 30-year average by the time we get to Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, back into the 70s and seeing a pretty good shot at some rain.
All right, looking forward to that rain, actually.
Mm-hmm.
All right, thanks so much, Luke.
Well, the water bottle experiment I did in my last full weather I thought was a little bit pathetic. Again,
yeah.
The
you
high
have to
pressure,
redeem yourself.
The high pressure at the center pushes on the water bottle.
Whoa! That went all the way across the studio.
Again, it causes that air to sink, and it causes not a lot of upper air motion, which kind of drives those thunderstorms. That's just sort of your little scientific tidbit here on ABC 17 News at 10. We're going to be seeing those temperatures back down into the middle 60s across the region, those southerly breezes taking over overnight. We're back into the upper 80s and lower 90s tomorrow with those heat index values back into the mid-90s.
All right, thank you so much, Luke. Come for the news, stay for the science, huh? But stick around. We also have Sports Zone with Andrew Kaufman next.